when you take shortcuts and you get away with them when you're younger, and you think you get away with them, the truth is, we're talking about this before the podcast, there just aren't any shortcuts.
Well, they they impede your development.
Yeah.
When something goes wrong, you have to address it. You address it, and that's how you get better. Everything that I've ever done where I fucked up on, it made me better. At everything I've ever done.
That's right.
It's just uncomfortable. You don't want to feel it.
I'm sorry to interrupt. That comes from also learning how to talk to yourself and being nice to yourself.
Yeah.
Not being too hard on yourself either. Like, this is a marathon, not a sprint.
Yeah.
Take it easy on yourself, you know?
And it also comes from building up like a database of you being a good person.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you have to really believe in yourself as a person. Like, you know, but mistakes and fuck ups and things that you do along the line, those are like hugely important. They really are. Because when you're developing as a human being and you're a young person trying to make your way through life, you're going to come across these situations where you do not know how to behave correctly.
Yeah.
Whether it's because of your emotions, whether it's because of your hormones, your insecurities, whatever the fuck it is, it's very possible for you to fuck up and make mistakes. But those mistakes are huge.
Yep.
All of those dumb things, those lefts when you should have went rights, all of those things can be, as long as they don't kill you, you can learn a lot from them.
I was talking to Bill Unger a long time ago, who produced a True Romance and all those movies. And I'd written something and I said, I'm trying to write this script, but it sucks. And he said, Brian, I know a lot of Academy Award winning writers and I don't know one of them that doesn't have a trunk full of scripts that are all shit. It took him a long time to get to that. Steven Soderbergh, I read an interview, and he's done 26 movies, but he said before Sex, Lies, and Videotape, he had five flops, you know, five terrible movies he made. He learned how to make a good movie by just making those mistakes. There are no exceptions.
Yeah. And if there are, I don't care.
They're not relevant. That's right.
Yeah.
That's right.
Maybe some people have figured out a way through life without fucking up.
Yeah, but you know, even in Malcolm Gladwell in Outliers was talking about Mozart, and we always say, well, Mozart was making music at six.
That music sucks.
Exactly. He said his real music that we listened to didn't start for 10, 15 years. Literally, he was 18 when he was making the music that you can listen to. So,
well, yeah, I mean,
that was Mozart.
Not to shit on Mozart or anything like that. I think it's the mistakes and the flaws and the fuck ups in life, they're so critical for a sense of humor.
Mm.
They're so critical for understanding boundaries and limitations. They're really critical, man. It's just, they suck when they happen, man.
Yeah.
Like bombing on stage is fucking terrible, but it's been one of like the biggest peaks in growth in my stand up career have come after like horrible, like
no doubt,
just devastating bombings.
Frank.
Where I was like, oh my God, I gotta regroup. And then when I regrouped, boom, I came back like way better. Like I just much more focused. I don't know what I had done that led me to bombing these few. I have like some peak bombings in my life where I go back and I look on them, like real like life changing bombings.
Oh, yeah, me
too. I have like
four
like meteor holes in my past
where I just
ate a million dicks on stage.
You're up there and it's forever.
Yeah.